व्यूवर्स, इट्स मी समीर खान एंड वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल सैम्स क्लासरूम। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द हेल्थ एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ एलिमेंट्री केनोल एंड माल न्यूट्रिशियस डिसीजेस। नो मैटर हाउ बैड वी ट्रीट अवर डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम, इट फंक्शंस रिमार्केबली, बट समटाइम्स इट रेबल्स एंड वी फील सिक। Vomiting is the body's method of getting rid of unwanted or harmful substances from stomach. Reverse peristaltic movements are produced by stomach and esophagus to expel the food. Reverse peristalsis is seen in ruminants like cow, buffalo, etc. They graze the grass and later sits leisurely and brings the grass back into the mouth through reverse peristalsis and chew it by adding with saliva. This process is called rumination. There are many causes of vomiting, but the most common one is because of overeating and high proportion of fat in food. Vomiting also occurs when we eat indigestible or poisonous food. When we eat rich meals for several days, we have greenish vomit, which is usually called as bilious or liverish. We get a bitter taste after this. Bilious vomit is a result of excessive fat in food. When liver is unable to cope up with the excessive fat, we get feeling of nausea, which means vomiting sensation. Healthy people can usually avoid the problems of indigestion by: first one is having simple and well-balanced meals. Second one is to eat them in a leisurely manner. Third one is thoroughly masticating the food. Fourth is to avoid taking violent exercise soon after eating the food. And the fifth one is drinking plenty of water and having regular bowel movements. A more serious problem of indigestion is caused in stomach and duodenal ulcers. These problems are more in people who are described as hurried and worried. Ulcers occur more often in busy people who get into the habit of hurrying while eating the food, and also in people who rush from one activity to another without sufficient rest. Proper functioning of all life processes require adequate amount of food. It is not just intake of food, but its assimilation and expulsion of waste plays an important role. Intake of fiber-rich foods avoid constipation. Now let us learn about malnutrition. Food is the main source of energy, which helps in maintaining biological process in a perfect manner. Our diet should contain proper amounts of carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals. Most of the people in the world are affected by food-related diseases. Eating food that does not have one or more than one nutrients in required amount is known as malnutrition. Malnutrition is caused because of several factors. Some of the factors which are affecting malnutrition are poor health, willful starvation, lack of awareness of nutritional habits, socio-economic factors are all the reasons for malnutrition in our country. Malnutrition is of three types. They are calorie malnutrition, protein malnutrition, protein calorie malnutrition. Kwashiorkor disease. This is a protein deficiency disease. In this disease, the body parts become swollen due to accumulation of water in the intercellular spaces. Poorly developed muscles and hair, fluffy or moon-shaped face, difficulty in eating, diarrhea, and dry skin are the symptoms of this disease. Marasmus. This is due to the deficiency of both proteins and calories. Lean and weak body, swelling in limbs, poorly developed muscles, dry skin, and diarrhea are the symptoms of this disease. Obesity. This is due to overeating and excess of energy intake. It is dangerous to health because obese people are target to many diseases like diabetes, cardiovascular problems, renal and gallbladder problems. If you like my video, then please do like, share, comment, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.